Lanza. I'm John Burnett Larkins. I'm very, very pleased to guide you through what has been called the triumvirate of exceptional bands. We will start off with the classic and refined sounds of the ISU Wind Ensemble. We will then segue to the toe-tap and finger-snap and sounds of Jazz Ensemble 1. And then, after a short break, to take some deep breaths, embrace yourself, the second half of our concert, when we will fill this stage, literally, with the undeniable in-your-face school spirit and the people who bring it to you, the cozy little ensemble with the longest name in the business. We call it the Iowa State University Cyclone Football Varsity Marching Band. And yes, some of the student musicians here tonight are performing in more than one of these ensembles. Not only are they good musicians, but they are good at costume changes, and in some cases, instrument changes too. Now for the first time, this event sold out several days ago. Its popularity is growing each year. We thank all of you for being here and helping this to become one of the most popular musical events of the year in Ames. And if you know someone who is unfortunately not able to get tickets, make sure next year you start pestering them early and tell them to grab those tickets online just as soon as they become available. Right now, it's time to get the program underway with the ISU Wind Ensemble, made up of the most talented wind, brass, and percussion musicians at Iowa State. The Wind Ensemble performs the finest and the most challenging music written for wind bands. They have had internationally known soloists, composers, and performers appear with them, including Julie Giroux, Frank Tekeli, the Boston Brass, John Philip Sousa IV, and Iowa's own Simon Estes. This past May, the Wind Ensemble performed at the Iowa Bandmasters Association Annual Conference. This year, they will be performing in Chicago's Orchestra Hall, and they will be performing concerts in Munich and Rothenburg, Germany, and in Salzburg, Austria. They'll open tonight's program with A London Sketch by film composer Vincent Oppido. The conductor of the Wind Ensemble is in his 26th year as director of bands at Iowa State University. He is an elected member of the prestigious American Bandmasters Association, a past national president of Kappa Kappa Psi National Honorary Band Fraternity, past president of the Big 12 Band Directors Association, past president of the Iowa Bandmasters Association, and currently on the board of directors for the John Philip Sousa Foundation. He has conducted 7 all-state bands, numerous honor bands nationally and internationally, and this year will serve as the guest conductor for the National Sun Yat-sen University Wind Ensemble in Taipei, Taiwan. Please join me in welcoming the director of bands at Iowa State University, Dr. Michael Galimo.
Thank you.
Our next section, selection tonight is entitled Carolian Jubilate, Jubilation in the Age of King Charles III. It was performed at the coronation ceremony for King Charles III, the King of England. And I want you to understand, listen carefully here, because this is indeed very, very special to you. You are all very fortunate to be here to hear this and witness this evening, because this performance tonight is the first time that this will be performed in America, right here this evening. Now, the music is very celebratory, and it takes you on a journey surrounded by the events of His Majesty the King's coronation in May of 2023, and it also offers a moment of reflection for Her late Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. The five elements of the music start with the arrival of the King's procession at Westminster and portrays the pomp and ceremony of the occasion with fanfares. This is then followed by Westminster Bells, a representation of the rejoicing of the bells of the Abbey. The Crown, the next movement, then focuses on the presentation of the magisterial crown. In the next section, Tears of a Nation and In Memoriam, reflects the sense of grief that England and the world experienced at the death of Her late Majesty. And finally, Live Long and Prosper provides fanfares and brass, wishing a long and prosperous reign for His Majesty King Charles III. Now, with us tonight is the composer of this selection, Lieutenant Colonel Craig Hallett. Colonel Hallett is the Principal Director of Music for the entire British Army and is in charge of the bands that perform for the Changing of the Guard ceremony at Buckingham Palace. He has previously been Senior Director of Music to the bands of the Household Division and Royal Bands, as well as Chief Instructor of the Royal Military School of Music. He's in his 39th year as a musician in the British Army, and we are indeed privileged and honored to have him here with us as a guest conductor and composer this evening. Please welcome Colonel Craig Hallett to the podium.
Thank you.
might indulge me just for a couple of minutes while I say a couple of thank yous to people over here. So I came across a couple of days ago at the invite of Dr. Mike, and what an experience I've had. I certainly think I was born in the wrong country. You guys are absolutely amazing, and these guys are even better. So, something John didn't mention is that I finished my career in a couple of weeks' time, and this is the last thing I'll do in uniform. So I can't think of a better way to finish, and for such an appreciative crowd as well, I am hugely grateful for the opportunity that's been offered to me. And I'd just like to say a couple of thank yous and also a quick presentation, if you allow me to make those quickly. So, Dr. Mike. So, as John said, I was involved in the coronation and the funeral, and the coronation of Her Majesty, and then the coronation of King Charles. And during that time, I was lucky enough to be a parade marshal, so I led the musicians on parade that day, and the parade marshal carries a special baton that is only used in the case of funerals, royal funerals or coronations. And I thought my visit here was so exceptional, and I wanted to leave a lasting memory of what's been a truly magnificent few days. So I've taken the parade marshal pattern from the funeral of Queen Elizabeth and the coronation of the King, and I've framed it this, and I'm presenting this to the university. So leave you in peace shortly, but I just wanted to say that, you know, it doesn't matter how old you get, it's never too late to meet lifelong friends, and those friends can appear at any time and in the most bizarre places. So how did Mike and I become friends, along with Mike's wife Mary Beth and their friends Karen and Greg? Well, we ended up at Buckingham Palace on a parade on the forecourt where we shouldn't have been, and where I was potentially going to lose my career. We got wrapped up in this parade by accident, and we ended up spending some time on Buckingham Palace forecourt with some of the royal family, literally about 10 feet away. So I think I certainly thought that it was the end of my career, but managed to get away with it, so I'm here. So I'd like to present Dr. Mike with, it's a baton case for conducting batons, but inside there are two batons. There's just a normal baton, but I've also put in there the last baton that I used as Director of Music of the Welsh Guards when I conducted on the forecourt at Buckingham Palace. It was the last baton that I used in charge of the Welsh Guards, and it was where we met, really, on the forecourt at Buckingham Palace. So I just wanted to give this to Dr. Mike, these batons, and say thank you very much for the opportunity. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Have a wonderful evening. We are so honored to have him with us. And if you notice the vest that he's wearing, the colors of his vest, cardinal and gold, did you all? Speaking of Cardinal and Gold, I happen to know the Lieutenant Colonel is going to be attending the football game tomorrow, and he is quite enthused about that. He's going to conduct our national anthem during the pregame ceremonies tomorrow as well. The Wind Ensemble will now conclude their portion of tonight's program with music from the American composer Frank Tekeli. This is the third movement of his Symphony No. 2 called Apollo Unleashed. Apollo was the ancient god of the sun, and therefore this piece features blazing energy, fast tempos, bright sonorities, and galloping rhythms, giving the work a sense of urgency and finality. With Dr. Michael Nemo back on the podium, this is Apollo Unleashed.